Hello and welcome to Let's Chat. My name's Ty and I'm going to tell you a super awesome secret today, but don't tell mom. No, don't. So, it's not funny. Hello, my name's Ty and I believe I can talk to anyone about anything and so can you. High five. So this is going to sound a little bit more of like a more of a ramble. But I had this really weird idea when I woke up this morning that I remembered what it was like being a little brother. And to just throw us back a little bit, my sister, I have an older sister, and I'm probably playing some B-roll of some random black kids because they didn't have VHS or anything like that back in the day. Not that far back, but at least far back to like the late 80s, 1980s. This is when I'm growing up as a kid, and I'm there being shuffled around to different neighbors' homes with my sister because we had to get babysat all over the place. So this is how it worked in the 1980s. This is how babysitting worked, especially if you're the only black family in the city. Your mom will take you and your sister, your older sister, in a car, drive you to a random stranger's house, knock on the door, and be like, hey, do you want to watch these kids for like $4? And they'd say, sure, we don't care. We know. And your mom will come back to the car and be like, this is where you live now when you get out of school. And be like, okay, thank you. What do you say to that? So, I mean, that's just how you rolled back then. So after school, I would go to these random people's houses. One of them, mostly just Mexican people, and they're all awesome. This is where my love for Mexican food came from. But that is another story, Tyrone, focus. So Catalina was one of our main babysitters growing up, for me and my older sister. And she had an older daughter who's like, you know, in her, you know, late high school career. And my sister was really psyched about that because this is like someone she could look up to. This is like a role model. This is awesome for her. But for me, this kind of sucked because now I'm just like the third wheel. I'm the little brother. I was like, what are you gonna do? So Pogs, no one plays Pogs even back then. I only had like, the only thing that existed to play with back then was like marbles and rocks. That's basically it. That's what life was like in the 1980s. It was just like, if you're poor, you had marbles and rocks and you had to choose which of two. And the rich kids had like the nice rocks. That's it. So you had to like figure that out. So anyway, so my sister and Catalina's eldest daughter hanging out, having a great time. Meanwhile, me and Catalina's four young sons, who are younger than I was even, and I think their name was Jose, Julio, and JJ. I'm not making those names up. Those are real names. We would all have to sit because the house is, okay. I think Catalina had some weird rules about boys, that many boys and that many girls being inside the house at the same time, or even like just the idea of that many kids in her home at the same time stressing her out. I could understand that. So what we'd all have to do was sit outside on this weird little porch and stare at each other in like the purview of like a window that was like adjacent to like, that could see into the kitchen, and sit and stare at each other outside until my mom came back home and allowed me and my sister to go back home and allow the boys to go back inside. So basically, I remember the day very clear, King City, California, 93906 Division Street, that porch waiting for my mom to come home, and I see the dumpster nearby and I'm like, guys, you wanna just grab a stick from that trash can over there and chase each other with it? I mean, we can call it trash stick, that's a game. You wanna just do that for a while? And everyone else is like, yeah. They had tiny voices because they were all literally four. And we ended up doing it, and it was super fun. You know what? We actually had way more fun than anybody else probably did that day. Like, it was insane. And it made not only just that time way more fun, but all the future times we'd get a whole bunch of stuff out of the dumpsters and start chasing each other with it. It was the fun thing to do. And you know what? I gotta be honest with you, I'd rather be doing that than what we were doing before. We really turned a bad situation into a good one. And I think when you go back to it, this is where I was going to with at least compliments and critical feedback. I feel like critical feedback always gets a bad rap. But ultimately, all it's trying to do is take a situation and improve it. And I think compliments are always going to be welcome at the door, but always will just be what they are. You know, it's just like, oh yeah, you confirmed exactly what I like about myself. No need to change whatsoever. that's great. But critical feedback, I feel like, is like that gross little brother that's like looking around the room being like, how about we play a nice game of trash stick? Like, even if it boils down to being chased with a stick from a dumpster, the intentions are still good and are all about trying to take a situation and improving upon it. And I feel like when you look at it that way, it's really not too bad. What do we mean about this in the long run? When I get a compliment, it's nice, but that's all ever it will be. But when I get critical feedback, not only is it nice because someone's trying to improve something for me, but it gives me the opportunity to improve myself at the same time. And that's something that I'll take with me and a way more fundamental than anything else. Like, I'm over 30. I'm old. I already demonstrated I'm pretty old. Like, right now, I think I'm 33 years old, and I'll probably never play a game of trash stick ever again. And that, and as silly as that sounds, that is something I'll miss way more than probably any kind of compliment that I got when I was a kid growing up. It's like, hey, you know, and I'll probably miss Jose, Julio, and JJ very much so. And those times that we had together were pretty awesome too. But like, I still grew up with those. Those are part of me now. And so I've forgotten the compliments I've gotten growing up, but I remember those times. And I feel like with critical feedback, if you're willing to grow with them, not only do you become a better person as a result, but you carry them with you way more than just the platitudes. And there's something really awesome about that. There's something really cool about little brothers. And that's what I wanted to share. That was a weird thought I had today. Okay, so that's about it. Hey, listen, that was kind of a weird story. Let's review. Critical feedback, not as bad as you thought. Maybe I put it in a weird context. Maybe we could talk about this later. I'd love to talk about it more. But yeah, compliments, not bad. Critical feedback, oh, let's get that trash stick, boy. Let's do it. It's a little bit weird, but anyway, thanks. That's the end of today's show. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks to my Patreons for this month. How about you guys go through the car wash? Okay, all right. Anonymous got something there. Okay, there's Matt Kova. He's getting washed up. Ooh, yeah, all right. Okay, there you go, Dan. All right, and we're done. if you guys want to learn more about street epistemology and how you can talk to anyone about anything, feel free to check out more vids in this channel or se-playlist.com, and you can learn more about having cool conversations with people. Anyway, see you guys. Bye.